Mr Speaker, this issue of people waiting in trolleys is a very serious one. The number doubled in December and now at its highest ever level on record. The Prime Minister promised to put the Conservative Party's inadequate NHS funding pledge into law. Can he explain why it is necessary to cement into law a pledge which the Health Foundation has said is below the amount needed to maintain current standards of care?
Mr Speaker, it's only under this Conservative government that we have the resources that will enable us to invest in our NHS. And it's because of the stewardship of the economy after the wreckage that Labour left when they were in office that we've been able to make those colossal investments. And I would remind him not only was it this Conservative government that rebuilt the A&E, as he correctly points out, it is this Conservative government that we'll be rebuilding the entire hospital.
Mr Speaker, I don't know if the Prime Minister had a chance to read the Labour manifesto in the election, but we made it very clear. We have a plan. We have a plan, a very clear one. It is free personal care, it is more funding, and it is support for carers. And I'm very happy to send him another copy of our manifesto so he can read it. The Prime Minister has said many times he's going to put this NHS funding issue into law. If he's really committed to fixing the crisis his government has created over the last decade, he should end the empty rhetoric and back our proposals to give the NHS the funding it needs rather than putting into law an insufficiency of funding. The NHS is our most precious national institution. Fund it properly that everyone can rely on it, those that cannot afford private health care.
Well, Mr Speaker, I'm delighted he's still fighting on the manifesto that he submitted to the attention of the British people at the last election. I think it was pretty clear what they thought of it, what they thought of the credibility of the promises that he made. But it was also clear what they thought of what we're going to do, because they see that we are the party of the NHS, Mr Speaker.